post graduation in MJR University, Madras, India. At the same time, he got many more fellowships. In the meanwhile, he is a person who has popularized hijama, is a type of cupping therapy, what we think in terms of Ayurveda, holistic
Rakta Mokshana,
blood thinning therapy, in all over the world. He is also an ambassador for peace from UK. In the same time, he has multi-centers in all over the world. Now, Dr. Beg is enlightening his knowledge to all of us regarding hijama. I welcome. In the same time, I'll give a mic to her. Thank you.
Good morning, Manmohan. I'm Dr. Ubaidullah Beg. My topic is theoretical and practical importance of hijama in Yunani system of medicine. I'm representing Yunani system of medicine from the past 18 years in different part of the world. Here, my topic is regarding the cupping therapy. We have different types of cupping. Usually what people thinks when cupping, the name will come, this is Chinese therapy. Not like that. Actually, we have regimental therapies in different part of our medicinal approach. And we have nutritional medicine, pharmacology, and one of the part of our system, Yunani system of medicine, is regimental therapy. In regimental therapy, one of the part is cupping, like leash therapy, like massage therapy is one of the part like this. Hijama also. I'm just giving the introduction about this hijama. So this is actually pure Arabic word. Cupping is actually the word which is coming from the Arabic al-hijm. That means to suck, to restore the original size. This is the main actually the term of this cupping. And the next slide. Yeah.
You have a remote here.
It's working.
For the slides, I think you are checking to go back.
Yeah, this is this introduction I'm just given. We have two types of cupping. One is the sunnah points. We have two types of cupping in normal in Yunani system of medicine. We are dividing in two ways. One is a scientific way. One is a prophetic way. What Prophet Muhammad ﷺ told regarding the cupping. I'm just correlating in between this sunnah and scientific way. Why we are doing the cupping in the specific points, and what is the importance, and what is the correlation in between the scientific research. That's the main motto to highlight this slide. This is a different types of names, what we are giving, what we are calling for the site of hijama, muhajim, This is all the Arabic terms, what in olden days, in the previous days, they are called Singi Lagwana, Singi Kichwana. Like this, the horn, this they are sucking the blood with the horn. And now this very sophisticated and very advanced type of cups is coming nowadays. Previously, they are sucking with the horns. And this historical background of the hijama is 1000 BC and Hippocrates, the father of medicine, 460 BC also is written in the book. And Avicenna also is mentioned his book, Al-Qanun Fitri, this canon of medicine. And this all this related to. But here, this what we are classification of hijama is wet cupping and dry cupping. Wet cupping is actually for the evacuation of the humors, which is abnormal humors accumulated in the blood. We are evacuating the blood with the humors, is abnormal humors, correcting the circulation. That is the main motto of doing wet cupping. But maximumly dry cupping are doing. The dry cupping is when the matter, which is unwanted matter, this is morbid matter, that by diverting to the other side, that is called the dry cupping. Wet cupping, directly we are removing the unwanted morbid matters from the body. This is a dry cupping, what I have shown to you. This is one more cupping is there, that is the fire cupping. The fire cupping also is doing in the local area. This is the wet cupping. What we are focusing on the wet cupping only. So many other types of cupping also is there, like the light cupping or medium cupping, strong cupping and all. This is massage cupping, needle cupping, herbal cupping. So many types of cupping there. The main focus is mechanism of hijama, mechanism of cupping. See, in the normal, what we are thinking, this there is no scientific evidence about this hijama at all. This study is done so many centers and so many different places and so many countries in the world. They are focusing on the specific subject and doing run the research. And some of the slides I'm showing here. See, this is the modern one. This is the our system of medicine, the Yunani aspect and modern aspect. Both the aspect you can see here. Well, this here, the local effect and systemic effect and the body parts of that. This is the another one, what I am showing this slide. This is the morbid matters we are evacuating from the body, and this is the permanent relief you will get, and this is the main focusing on the disease creating matter. That is the main focus on the, this is the procedure what we are doing in hijama, in cupping therapy. And this, you can see this mode of action. And diversion of this, already I am told this regarding this slide. This is the one theory is there, we are doing hijama on specific days. Why we are doing this specific day, 17, 19 and 21st. This 3 days we are doing, but we are focusing on that. Because the humus is near to the surface of the skin. This is also proven in the scientific research. That the specific days, the lunar effect will come in the body, and the body surfaces is close to expel this morbid matter. For that reason, we are sucking the morbid matter from the surface of the skin. This is the reason why we are doing this 19th, 21st and 17 and 21st. And scientific sunnah point. This is what is, I will show you the point, the 7th cervical point. The point which we are going to focus maximum cases of this cupping therapy, this specific point that is called 7th cervical. This cervical area and 7th cervical vertebra, we are putting the cup and we are excreting the blood. We are extracting the blood from there. That is the importance of this one. I will show you this correlation between sympathetic outflow and parasympathetic outflow. This all this is correlation in between the specific sunnah points, what 7th cervical is there. This, see, this all these things is the total. If you're going for the in detail, I will tell you about the anatomy and all these things. You're all well known about all the doctors here, which they are knowing about all the pathology and anatomy and all. All these details of this is the parasympathetic outflow. What I'm given this the 9th and 10th, this vagus nerves correlation in between your this point. Then and then local injury effect in hijama. What is this? Is this is planned in injury? This is focusing on that specifically. The we are giving a scar and we are giving a planned. Planned injury, but we are not. This is not like the blood is drawing from like this. Without focusing anything, we are planning the. We are giving the injury, the effect, the local injury effect will come in the body, and what will happening after that in the scientific research I'm showing here. See, inflammatory effect is there in specific site. Due to the immune response, role of RBC. What is the role of RBC? What is happening in that? That also is clearly mentioned. I'm just describing about this slide. And role of epidermal growth factor. That also is what happening in this. What is the correlation between hijama and epidermal growth factor? And this thing. What is happening in this? Is completely correlated with the scientific research and this evidence based and evidence we are given all the points why we are extracting the morbid matters and what is the benefit. Even the blood which we are extracting, that blood also we are sent it to the laboratory, and what kind of substances is there in the blood, that also is completely evidence based. This is indication of what kind of diseases we can do here. So this cupping, all these things we can know, frozen shoulder, knee pain, osteoarthritis, all these things we can go for this one. I'm just going with quick one. Otherwise, I will explain each and every slide. Indication. And this is the precautions. Precautions also is very important. See. Whenever you're doing a cupping, we have to go with the precautions. That also is very important during the menstruation and during this very severe anemia and all. We have to wait to the patient. All those things, we have precautions. Some of the precautions we have to take the patient. Even those are taking blood thinners and all, beta blockers. All those that kind of patients we have to keep, first. We have to withdraw the medicine, and then 3 days afterwards we have to go for the cupping. And this, all these things, instructions is given. Material method and method, all these things I will explain about it. And this one, material method and this primer. What first we have, I'm just simply explain about this method. I'm not going in detail about it. Just we are placing a cup in the specific area and leaving for 2-3 minutes. And when this area will completely, that area is completely anesthetic, because due to the negative pressure that we after that again we are giving small scars and withdrawing the blood, and then 3 minutes after 4 minutes again we are going to dispose. That's all. This is the simple method. This removal of cup, 3 to maximum 10 minutes, but 3-4 minutes is enough for that withdrawing the cup. And precautions, what kind of precautions we have to take. This slide, you can see this one. And post hijama, most probably post hijama means after doing that, we are advising some of the things to the patient, what you have to avoid. Non-vegetarian food and other type of blood thinners and all. Immediately after doing this cupping, you have to stop. And then 2 or 3 days after, you can go for this second one. And this follow-up also is very important. And the complications usually when we are not taking precaution, that time the complications will come. Otherwise, when we have very planned and very doing very carefully, means there is no any complications. Usually in the camp, what we are seeing in the lot of patients who are doing at the same time, with 150, 200 patients, that time some of the complications we are seeing, like the some of the patients are coming without knowing this instructions. That time, some of the complications we are seeing in the clinical side. This vomiting, blisters, this is common complications. and consent form. This also you have important for the each and every patient. When we are going, this, we have to sign the consent form, because that is important one. And this is the what I told the points. This is the sunnah points, and this is general point. This is the sunnah. This is like 9 points. What we are advised by the our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is a I told before that there's two ways we are doing hijama. One is a scientific way. One is a religious way. One. This is the points. Nine points. We are doing in this sunnah way. And this is the general points. And this is the scientific points. What advised by this authentic books. What I'm just quoted here. You can see these points for the epilepsy. And this is the muscle cramps or all types of muscle injury. And this is meningitis. This is a headache. 3 points you have to do. This is a chronic headache. And this is paranoia. Melancholia also we are putting. This is hemiplegia, Bell's palsy. And this is a coma and Parkinson's. This is the points of loss of memory. We can do all these points. You just keep in mind for doing this therapy. Even in this point, you can do the normal without going for the wet cupping. You can do dry cupping also. Dry cupping also you can do in these points.
What is the difference between dry and wet?
Dry cupping is only the cup are placed on that area, and the internal morbid matter have to divert to one place to another place. That's all. Then you will get relaxed. Because of the morbid matter, the circulation will block.
You are not doing any bloodletting there.
Dry cupping, we are not doing any.
Just you are creating pressure.
Yeah, negative pressure and giving this slow move to one place to another place. That's all.
Okay, that is
dry cupping.
The wet cupping is?
Wet cupping, we are directing, extracting blood from there in the specific area, and directly the disease will come out. Because of most of you know about loss of circulation, loss of nutrition cause necrosis. Simple theory. If it is circulation is clear, then the morbid matter is not there much in the blood. The circulation will be there in the normal way. If it is obstructing there, then we are removing the obstruction and we are evacuating the morbid matter. You will get clear immediately. This is the for the hiccup. This is the for the kidney pain and the normal, even you can do, we have seen so many patients, those are doing normal dialysis patients, we are doing cupping, is very good result, because this is also is a, we can say one of the method is a small dialysis, because the same function is going to create this specific area, but in the not in the major way, is a very
little. You are doing dry cupping there.
Yes, not wet cupping. Wet cupping is very advisable for the kidney patients. Those are kidney failure patients.
So, what will be the serum creatinine and blood urea
levels?
Let me complete the question.
Yeah.
What were the serum creatinine and urea levels
before and after
when you are doing the cupping, and
after that cupping?
What is the level you are not doing the cupping? Contraindication.
Limitation.
Yes, sir. Usually in this initial stage, those are going for the regular basis once in a month or twice in a month. They after doing the cupping, what we are seeing in the clinical side is reduced. The number of dialysis what they are doing is reduced. Those are going for the 4 times in a month, they are reduced 2 times in a month. That is what we are seeing in the clinical side. This is for the kidney stone, this menorrhagia, and the prolapsed uterus, this amenorrhea, this all the premature ejaculation, these points, this diabetes mellitus, pneumonia, cervical spondylitis, frozen shoulder, and tennis elbow, upper back pain, and lower back pain, this is arthritis points. Sciatica is very excellent results in this one. Within 5 to 7 minutes, your pain will disappear after doing this cupping. 5 to 7 minutes. A very excellent result. What we are seeing.
Dry or wet?
Wet cupping. Because you know about what kind of pain is in the sciatic patients. A very horrible pain. After doing the cupping, completely the pain will disappear. after nearly 15 days, you will get little bit slowly the pain will appear. Before that, we can do other time also the cupping same one.
Only one spot or all the spots?
This all the spots.
At the time you are doing that?
Yes. Same, we have 7 cups we have to put in the one area.
Okay.
And after 15 minutes it will go over. 15 to 20 minutes maximum.
You are taking a sucking effluent in all the 7 cups?
Yes, 7 cups. Because the what the origin is there from the shatic nerve, from there to last point.
So the diameter of cup is like varied, right? So that in all the spots, the diameter of the cup should be uniform, or it can be...
This is the same points you have to keep.
No, the diameter of the cup is the same.
Okay, this is the last slide what I am shown. Thank you very much for giving an opportunity to share knowledge with you all. Thank you very much.
Yeah, Dr. Appan, any questions? We'll go for a tea then.
Doctor, you start your treatment only after all the medical investigations are done.
Yes, definitely. After medical.
Is there any way that you identify where you can find the morbid matter by your own way? Or
no.
You have to go through the clinical investigations?
No, not needed. Because see,
is there any way you can find out the morbid matter?
No, this is a part of the treatment in the regimental therapy. First, I explained about what kind of treatment we are giving. We are not blindly giving any patient to this therapy. We are giving the patient those are already affected with specific diseases like sciatica, like other cervical spondylitis, all this thing. Already we have complete detailed history of the patient, and then according we are deciding. See nowadays what is happening everywhere. Cupping means everyone can do. This is not like a thing. Only the physician, those are having specific knowledge on that and they have the practical knowledge on the specific subject. He can do the cupping. Otherwise, it's not advisable. Nowadays we are seeing in everywhere. The cupping board you can see, but that is not a way to appreciate that kind of people. Those are non-qualified. I am very against about the we are formed on committee or ethical committee also for that. Those are practicing non-qualified one. We have to condemn all this kind of activities like this. Thank you.
Yeah. I think Dr. Priya regarding JAMA in detail. I think it's a new area for the whole country.